So big question is, what should be the target systolic blood pressure in a patient who is non-diabetic and has hypertension? Should the target be less than 120 or less than 140? So SPRINT trial was conducted, published in NEJM this year. 9,300 patients, age more than 50 were included. Systolic BP was 130 to 180. And at least these patients were non-diabetic and had at least one cardiovascular risk factor. These risk factors were defined as age more than 75, which were 28% in this study, CKD, cardiovascular disease, remaining up 10 years CVD risk score of more than 15, which was there in almost 60% of patients. Mean age was 68, as I told that mean patients who are elderly, more than 75, were almost 28% in this study. Baseline systolic BP was 139, diastolic was 78, eGFR was 72 at the entry point. Intensive treatment, this treatment was at the discretion of physicians. Intensive treatment was less than 120 and standard treatment where target was less than 140. Follow-up was for 1 year. This patient, almost 43% were on statin, almost 50% were on aspirin also. Primary endpoint was composite of MI, other acute coronary syndrome, stroke, heart failure or death from cardiovascular causes. Systolic BP in intensive treatment was just around 120 at the end of study, while it was about less than 140, of course, in the patient who was on standard care. What was primary outcome? The patients who were on intensive treatment did better. Composite of MI, ACA, stroke, heart failure or death due to cardiovascular causes was significantly less with intensive arm. P-value was highly significant. And similarly, all-cause mortality was significantly less with intensive treatment. As far as individual components are concerned, there was no much difference in myocardial infarction, acute coronary syndrome or stroke. That was slightly surprising. Stroke was not reduced. But heart failure, death from cardiovascular cause and death from any cause was significantly less with intensive treatment. Side effects, hypertension as expected was more common with intensive treatment. Electrolyte abnormality and acute kidney injury was also significantly more with intensive treatment. So message from this trial was that among hypertensive patients with high risk for cardiovascular events, but patients who had no diabetes, targeting systolic BP less than 120 as compared to less than 140 resulted in lower rates of fatal and non-fatal major adverse cardiac events and deaths from any cause. There were significantly higher rates of some adverse events, that is hypertension, electrolyte imbalance and acute kidney injury. People more than 75 years of age also had similar benefit.